Hello everyone and welcome back to another album review, and in this video I'm going to review I've Seen All I Need to See by The Body. This is a brand new work of The Body, which is a duo who mostly go into directions of like drone metal and sludge metal, but they also incorporate some harsh electronics to their works with elements of like harsh noise and power electronics, which is a sound that we see becoming more and more apparent with their latest releases incorporating more industrial and electronic elements rather than just sludge and drone metal. And in the past decade they've done multiple stuff, they've released a lot of albums, and even if they always try to experiment with something more, they definitely have a signature sound when it comes to the whole pacing of the songs, the structures, and especially when it comes to the distinct vocals. This makes some of the experimentations work amazingly and creating some really interesting works, but it also makes some other albums feel like being kind of the same, with albums where they've done things that we've seen them doing better in the past. This brand new work over here seems to focus much more on the electronic side of things and the industrial soundscapes. There are still elements of like sludge and drone metal, but it's mostly the electronic and the industrial elements that truly shine in this album. It fits more with like some of the experimentations they did with the two collaborative projects with Full of Hell, and like I said, it's a sound that we've seen getting incorporated more with newer releases. Take examples, the one from last year, I Don't Ever Want to Be Alone, with MSC, which was mostly an electronic release with elements of death industrial and power electronics. So I didn't really know what to expect getting into this album, but unfortunately I feel that this is one of those albums where The Body don't really develop their sound that much further. It's an okay album for what it is, but it's one of those occasions where we've heard stuff like this from The Body in the past and done much better. This album has an extreme amount of distortion in some occasions, but some of the textures are not really my style, as those really distorted elements are mostly incorporated in really low frequencies, so I feel that something like sort of misses, or like it sounds a bit cheap. There are some occasions where I don't really enjoy the mixing, with some of the elements just sounding much more overblown compared to others. And especially when it comes to the vocals, this is another album that has the signature vocal style that we know and love from The Body, but in some occasions the mixing of the vocals feels like it's really low, to the point where I can't really grasp what is going on for the most part. But this is not something that is happening all the time, but the overall balance of this album feels a bit off in some occasions. In terms of experimentation, there are definitely some pretty interesting elements. The track A Lament, for example, I think it's a really interesting introduction and one of the better moments in this album. In the first half, you get these glitchy cutout portions where the track abruptly stops playing and then it goes back again. And you know, when you listen to it at first, you feel that your PC just buffered, but no, this is actually part of the mixing process. I think the track shines more though in its second half, where it gets more melodic and you have those more dark and emotional moments, which in my opinion make for some of the better material for The Body. I like when they go into those simple and powerful riff sections, and it's kind of unfortunate that we don't get many elements like this in the rest of the album. For the most part, the whole thing just feels really flat, without having that much of like a sense of a melody to it, or something that would convey any sort of emotion, other than just few elements of dark and anger. I think though that the album melodically could have definitely done more, as hitting the same note over and over again without that much of a development to it doesn't really work all that well in all of the occasions. The main moments where I felt the album was getting more intense and having a bit of a more punch to it was with the tracks Tied Up and Locked In and with The City Is Sealed. Definitely my two favorite moments out of this album. The main issue with Tied Up and Locked In is how ridiculously short it is. It is by far the shortest track out of this album, and I definitely wanted more out of it. The City Is Sealed gives such a great impression from the beginning, with those great industrial sections, and then it comes this really heavy repetitive snare that I think sounds really cool. Another occasion where I feel that the album does something interesting in terms of experimentation is with the track They Are Coming. Mainly those parts where you have those bass drops that are filled with a ridiculous amount of distortion and the overall thing sounds really overwhelming. Other than that though, the rest of the track listing feels really forgettable, especially with the track A Pain of Knowing, which was extremely underwhelming. This track feels like it drags for so long and there is nothing really special about it in terms of its development and its structure. It is an extremely underwhelming track. And towards the end, we get the two tracks, The Handle, The Blade, and Path of Failure, where at this point it's really apparent that we don't get more development in this album. The two final tracks just feel really boring. And we're also talking about a kinda short album that is only 8 tracks, but there's not really that much to it. Most of the album feels one-dimensional, with passages and textures being repeated over and over. So yeah, like I said before, I feel that the body's discography is pretty inconsistent, so I didn't really get into this album with high expectations because I really don't know what to get with the body, because even if they usually have the same formula for the majority of their albums, sometimes it works, others not so much. This feels like a type of album from the body that we've heard before and also done better. And that's all there is to it, honestly. It is a standard The Body project that I feel that fans can definitely enjoy. There are certainly some appealing moments over here, but it's certainly not one of those albums where I see further development from the duo or having their greatest and most captivating ideas. I'm going to give I've Seen All I Need to See a 6+ out of 10. What's your opinion on this album? Like it? Dislike it? Why? And what do you want me to review next time? Let me know down in the comments. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video, subscribe for more content like this. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video. Goodbye.